to say to those of you that are struggling out there with COVID, that God is not going to fail you. Remember, even though I walk through the valley of COVID, I will fear no evil. For God, you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. In Jesus' name, come on. God is near and God is not going to forsake you. I just feel that I have to pray for you tonight. So if you have COVID, symptoms of COVID in your body tonight, maybe lying in a hospital, maybe lying in your bed, maybe sitting in your home tonight, I want to say this to you. Let's not be afraid. You know, fear is such a powerful weapon of Satan that robs us of our confidence in God. And I know that some people go through this quickly, other people go through this longer, but we are believing God that you are going to come through in Jesus' name. So come on tonight, put your hand on your chest, put your hand on yourself tonight, because the Bible says believers will lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. You are a believer and you lay hands on yourself, and in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I command you to be healed in Jesus' name. I speak to your respiratory system. I speak to your blood. And I said, live, yea, live in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord Jesus, I thank you through this camera tonight that you stretch forth your hand and that you heal your children, that signs and wonders may be done by the name of your holy servant Jesus. We magnify you and we pray for those in this valley tonight, all over South Africa, Father. You are a merciful God, and we pray that you send your hand of healing right now in Jesus' name. I command symptoms to desist. I command the spirit of death to go. I break the spirit of infirmity off of your life, and I say you will live and you will not die in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, God is good. God is in control. I'm not afraid. Come on, say it tonight. Say it tonight. No matter how you feel, come on. Come on, you are my strength. You're always there for me. In John chapter 3, the Bible says, as Moses lifted up that serpent, even so, the Son of Man must be lifted up. So tonight we lift Jesus Christ up all over the nations of the earth. We lift Jesus Christ up in your home tonight. We lift Jesus Christ up in the intensive care units of South Africa and Africa and the nations of the world. Come on, we lift up the name of Jesus. Come on, believers, all over, praying tongues right where you sit in the home, as we pray for those fighting for their lives, as we pray those that have, pray for those who have been bitten by this COVID virus in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's pray. Let's pray. Let's pray for our brothers and our sisters. Let's pray for those in hospitals. Let's pray for the medical staff. Let's pray for the doctors. Let's pray for our families that are fighting this disease. Come on, come on, come on. Father, we ask that you remove this plague from people that have been touched by this virus, by this disease. In the name of Jesus, we pray, Father, that the numbers will come down. We pray that your people will live and not die. In the name of Jesus, we pray for a move from heaven. We pray for an outpouring of the Holy Ghost. Father, you promised when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard against him. Father, you promised the battle is not yours, but the Lord's. And you fought that battle for us 2,000 years ago. So we say it tonight, Father. We position ourselves before the throne room of grace. Oh, come on. There in your hospital bed, there in your sick bed tonight, you position yourself before the throne of grace in time of need so that you may obtain help in the name of Jesus. My help comes from the Lord who made the heavens and the earth. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want for healing. I shall not want for peace. I shall not want for provision, because the Lord is my shepherd. The price has been paid. The blood has been shed. I command life in the name of Jesus. Life in the name of Jesus. Life in the name of Jesus. And for those that are critical, Father, oh Father, as their families have prayed for them, we stand in the gap for people tonight on ventilators. We stand in the gap tonight for people fighting, Father, people in panic, people that are anxious, people that are afraid. We ask, Holy Spirit, that you will come, that you will pour out your love in the hearts of your people, Father, that you will bring a peace that surpasses all understanding to our people. in our world in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You promised, Father, even when we have tribulations in this world, we don't have to fear because you are with us, Father. You will never forsake us. You will never leave us. So tonight we lift our eyes above the troubles in our land. We lift our eyes above the problems. We lift our eyes above this COVID. And we look unto you, Jesus, and we put our trust in you tonight. And we pray that you heal our land, Father. We pray that you heal our land tonight in the name of Jesus. We're not talking about physical, geographical land. Our land means our people. We cry out for our people. Father, we stand between the living and the dead. We position ourselves before the throne of grace. And we cry out to you, Father, to heal our land, to heal your church, to heal your people, to heal the economy, to heal our government. Father, we pray that you pour out your spirit. And tonight we unite as believers. You said one puts 1,000 to flight, 2 10,000. Father, you said when the enemy comes in like a flood, your spirit will lift up a standard against him. You taught us to pray, Lord Jesus, let your kingdom come, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Oh, Father, we pray for an intervention. And we pray for this beautiful land of ours, South Africa, and believers all over Africa, whatever your country, in Russia, in Pakistan, wherever you are tonight, pray for your country, pray for your government, pray for your nation, pray for your future. Come on, church, that's what we do.